Check, check.
Good evening, everyone. Can you please start taking your seats? If you can please start heading off to your seats. Buenas noches a todos y todas. Por favor, comiencen a dirigirse a sus asientos. Muchas gracias.
Thank you.
Hi everyone. We would like to ask everybody to take your seat. We are about to start.
Buenas noches a todos. Pedimos que tomen sus asientos. Vamos a empezar muy pronto. Gracias. Thank you.
Thank you. Por favor, tomen sus asientos, que en 30 segundos empezamos la ceremonia. Bien. La democracia cruje.
Democracy.
La corrupción.
Cracks. Corruption.
Una gangrena sistémica.
Is a systemic gangrene.
La justicia se ve cada vez más tuerta.
We see it all the time. That is misaligned. The
sword
that has a misses impunity.
La muerte acecha porque el crimen organizado avanza.
Because the organized crime progresses. Also, stop institution, the industry
falsas.
Of the fake news.
Manipula cifras,
manipulates
hechos,
the numbers and the facts,
rostros, voces,
faces, voices.
Inocula temor en
inoculates the fear in the population. I insist that death is out
en
there.
Medio de ello,
and in the middle of there, the good
de
journalism
goes
and erupts. The good journalism, like the oxygen for citizens, to defend freedom, the right to life, and to defend something that is so important, such as those pieces of happiness that sometimes is so difficult to achieve. So that's why tonight we are so happy to extend our hand from Santiago de Chile, from this country, to all journalists around the world, to all organizations that fight for the freedom of speech of the press. We give you our hands because today, more than ever, we need to hold your hands to commemorate a day that belongs to us, to the good journalism, the World Day of the Freedom of Press. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Since this is a civil celebration, and we would like to thank all the local and international authorities. We're not going to name you. They are here because we are commemorating, like us, we are celebrating this oxygen for citizens. We remember once again that the freedom of press do not belong to us, not to the media, not to the journalists, not to the communicators. That's the oxygen of the citizens. We are just an instrument that is our tool for them to defend themselves. And that's why let me greet today, first of all, to our guest of honor, to a woman that pleased us to be here, and we will continue celebrating for a long time. Maria Ressa, World Prize of Press Freedom, World Press Freedom Prize, and Nobel Prize of Peace. Maria was explaining in her book How to Fight Against a Dictator that it was necessary to have alerts of this social system based on the lies. There are peoples and companies that are looking to manipulate our emotions, to think the way we think, and even to the ones we vote. Maria, that's what we need to do. That is an example to follow. Well, let's say that today we are telling who is giving us the support, which is UNESCO and the Guillermo Cano Foundation. Because when we are in Chile, we need to remember that Guillermo Cano will continue enlightening us from Colombia by saying what journalism should do when the debt is around. In the 1980s, when we still were able to listen to the typewriter of Guillermo Cano in the areas of in different islands of the Expectator newspaper, hundreds of journalists around the world were facing the huge challenge to guarantee the access of citizens to the vital information. In Chile, it was the same thing. Since the coup d'etat in September 11, 1973, the exercise of the exercise of press and also the journalism in Chile was repressed with a brutal violence by the new civic and military areas. It was a murder, torture, and there's many of our colleagues in this land. And we eliminated as well to many of the media. Some others were dominated by the force. All of this to try to hide or to manipulate the truth. Many of them had to go to the exile to protect their lives and the lives of their families. Some others, they continue risking their lives here just to keep everybody informed to defend life, because that's what the good journalism do in case of a dictatorship. The bullets will silence the hearts, but not the words. The truth cannot be killed by murdering, attacking, or persecuting journalists. Because in Chile, such as in other countries under the terror as it is today, the truth is always come to the surface, and in Chile was open since the very same day of the coup d'etat. Yes, it is true. They were never able to hide all the truth. We build it from the inside. Sometimes we're just a small little bit of water in a creek. It was just a little bit of water in this river, but sometimes we came with a huge flow to defend the ones that wanted to be murdered. And in the 80s, in a context that was set by the repression, the death, and the torture, we've got the demonstration, the protest, the population was not happy, and many journalists. You know what? I have their faces here with me. They are walking in front of me. They continue working. We were the last link of this chain with the protecting life and freedom. Yes, because in that river that I was talking about, there were so many citizens that they were providing information by risking their lives, and we were the last link in that chain. We were just drops in a river fed by hundreds and thousands of citizens. Sometimes we were just a little bit of water till that flow of water erupted once again. That is why in this link, in this gathering of people, we really wanted to provide to this homage to a group of brave people that resisted the dictatorship by a media that was challenging all the time all the obstacles to report what was happening. That is teleanalysis. I would like to invite you to watch just a little bit of what was a teleanalysis and what it represented here in Chile.
La idea era que el análisis pudiera dar a conocer algo de lo que era Chile en ese momento.
Lo hacía porque quería denunciar, porque sentía que era lo único que yo podía hacer.
El camarógrafo un poco decía, ya, tenemos lo que vinimos a buscar. Vámonos. Vámonos porque si nos agarran, perdemos el material.
Estamos hablando del año 83, 84, 85. Está saliendo a la calle a protestar, a demandar, bueno, distintas cosas, a demandar democracia.
Cuando vivimos la dictadura, la vivimos sabiendo que lo que aparecía en un diario, en una radio o en la televisión, no era la verdad. Era al contrario, era una manipulación de la realidad para hacernos creer algo.
Miraba a través del visor y vi muchas cosas muy injustas, o sea, más que injustas, inhumanas.
Me doy vuelta, otro disparo. Veo a un carabinero del...
Ahí está. Esa imagen de la María Paz Santibáñez cuando la balean en el Teatro Municipal.
Era una estudiante de música y en una manifestación estudiantil en el centro de Santiago ella recibe un disparo de carabinero a muy corta distancia.
Los que lo grabaron se dieron cuenta de que estaban grabando algo súper fuerte y se van a la oficina de Teleanálisis, orientados por Augusto Góngora en ese momento. Fue como, hagamos copias de esto, de este material.
Entonces rápidamente esto lo mandamos a los canales de televisión para que los canales de televisión se hicieran cargo de que esto había pasado. La versión oficial no pudo competir con nuestras imágenes.
Hola, ¿cómo te llamas tú?
Carlos Vivanco.
¿Qué edad tienes?
11 años.
11 años. ¿De dónde vienes tú?
De la población de Villa Arturo Prat.
Niño, mi niño, tu niño y aquel niño, todos van. Rueda que te rueda hacia la vida nueva llegará. Cada niño un poco, todos tomarán de la misma leche y del mismo pan, de la misma leche y del mismo.
Yo creo que si uno ve las imágenes de Teleanálisis, puede ir a encontrar imágenes que son bien sintéticas o simbólicas de qué era Chile, cómo era Chile, cómo eran las preocupaciones, cómo éramos los chilenos.
Han mantenido las viudas y familiares de Santiago Natino, Manuel Guerrero y José Manuel Parada.
Y Augusto Góngora en algún momento dijo, bueno, este Chile invisible, ¿no? que nadie puede ver. Nosotros tratar de darle alguna visibilidad.
Nuestra preocupación era más bien exhibirlo y que la mayor cantidad de personas posibles lo viera.
Centros de alumnos, centros de estudiantes, sindicatos, parroquias, se juntaban a ver Teleanálisis. Y eso, aparte de lo que se veía, también generaba una cosa colectiva.
Esta es una cinta de VHS y aquí venían los programas de Teleanálisis. Aquí esto tenía la capacidad para más o menos 6 programas. Dentro del cassette iba la descripción del contenido de cada uno del último programa.
Les ayudaban de alguna manera a tomar conciencia, sobre todo primero a tomar conciencia sobre la injusticia, sobre la violencia, sobre la dictadura que estábamos viviendo y de alguna manera a empoderarse a hacer algo, lo que fuera, a poner un granito de arena para que esto se terminara, ¿no?
Luego del homicidio del periodista José Carrasco, redactores de los medios clausurados y dirigentes del Colegio de Periodistas recibieron constantemente amenazas de muerte y amedrentamiento.
Aquí está Pepe Carrasco, colega, compañero, amigo, asesinado por la dictadura después del atentado a Pinochet, vecino además. Trabajamos juntos en la revista y me tocó ante el análisis hacer un reportaje sobre su asesinato. Entonces eso es súper importante, poner de relieve que éramos un grupo y que cada uno de nosotros puso un grano de arena para lograr vencer esa censura, para lograr que esas imágenes y esos sonidos llegaran hasta nuestros días y hoy en día sean un patrimonio del cual podemos todos recordar y visualizar lo que ocurrió en aquellos años.
El Teleanálisis fue en algunos momentos porque lo escuchamos de la gente con la, a la cual íbamos a reportear, en comunidades, en poblaciones, diciendo, sigan haciendo lo que están haciendo, es importante para nosotros, o sea, nos alentaban a seguir adelante. Y eso indicaba que mantenía viva la esperanza.
This is so touching that I almost fell because of this emotion. And also, they said that I should introduce myself because maybe you don't know me. Maybe the Chileans know me. My name is Monica Gonzalez. I'm a Chilean journalist, part of that wonderful group of people. And I'm here because, well, in 2010, I was awarded with this prize, and that's why they asked me to be here tonight. But I would like to say that this is just a sample of a wonderful group that I allowed myself to give this homage, because it is a moment when we didn't have any ego. We protected ourselves. We loved each other. We were helping each other. We were, first of all, Chilean journalists for democracy and freedom. So with God, Jose Carrasco was murdered on September 8, 1986, 3 months before that they murdered in Colombia to Guillermo Cano. And in the middle of all that, we've got the image of a man that always fed us, that inspired us to continue, Gabriel García Márquez. That's why I want to provide an homage today to our friends from Telanálisis, Fortín Mapocho, Cauce, APSI, I don't know if I mentioned Radio Cooperativa, Mensaje Magazine, Radio Chilena. Never. We will never forget a wonderful page that the good journalism wrote in Chile. And now we need to give the floor to the music, because that's how journalists are. We love the music. We love to fight. We would like to inform and to love. So I would like to introduce to Gonzalez and the assistant, and they are not members of my family. This is just a coincidence.
Sí, buenas noches. Contarles que estábamos convocados con don Raúl Zurita hoy día. Él iba a estar declamando sus poemas. No pudo, fuerza mayor. Y aquí vamos con los textos del Desiertos de Amor 1, es este. Glaciares se acercan, grandes glaciares sobre los techos de nuestro amor. Ronca, gritó mi lindo, los dinosaurios se levantan, los helicópteros bajan y bajan. Donde yacen los viejos galpones, las paredes muy altas con torres de televisión. Tú podrías aparecer en las pantallas, oh sí, amor. En mis sueños enciendo el dial y allí apareces en blanco y negro. Digo, este es el chico que soñaba. Este es el chico que soñaba. Cuando despierto solo hay heridos en un largo patio, cueros cabelludos colgando de las antenas. Oigan amigos, les grité, esas épocas ya pasaron. Solo se rieron de mí. Marcaron a los muchachos y a bayonetazos les cortaron el pelo. Fumas marihuana, aspiras neopren. ¿Qué mierda fumas, rojo asqueroso? Pero son lindos. Aún así yo me arreglo de verlos. Mojo la cama y fumo. Yo me enamoro de ellos. Me regio y me pinto entera. Envuelta en lágrimas, los saludos. Pero todos sueñan hoy el sueño de la muerte. Oh, sí, lindo chico. Grandes glaciares vienen a llevarse los restos de nuestro amor. Grandes glaciares vienen a tragarse los nichos de nuestro amor. Las nicherías están unas frente a las otras. De lejos parecen bloques. Todo lo vi mientras me daban. Pero me viré y mi guardián no pudo retenerme. Allí conocí los colores y vi al verdadero Dios gritando dentro de los helados galpones de concreto. Aullando dentro de los fantasmales galpones de concreto. Mula chilena, me insultaba mi madre. Ya llegará también tu hora. Me viré por muchos lugares y vi a mis viejos sin salir de allí. Mula chilena, me insultaba mi madre. Son como Dios. Pero ellos no saben que su cachorra se está muriendo de amor y golpes en los viejos galpones. Ahora me buscan, pobres viejos ateridos, preñándonos de gruesos escupitajos juntos. Jóvenes y viejos reventaremos. Ay, amor, reventaremos. Ay, amor, reventaremos. La generación sudaca canta folk, baila rock, pero todos se están muriendo con la vista vendada en la barriga de los galpones. En cada nicho hay un país. Están allí. Son los países sudamericanos. Grandes glaciares vienen a recogerlos. Blancos glaciares, sí, hermanos, sobre los techos se acercan. Murió mi chica. Murió mi chico. Desaparecieron todos. Desiertos de amor. Desaparecieron todos. Desiertos de amor. Ay, amor, quebrados caímos y en la caída lloré mirándote. Fue golpe tras golpe, pero los últimos ya no eran necesarios. Apenas un poco nos arrastramos.
We were dragging amongst the dead bodies just to be together, to be right next to each other. Loneliness, it is not that hard. Nothing has happened really. I mean, dreams are rising and falling as always. As the days go by, as the night comes and goes, all of my love is here, and it stays here, right next to the rocks, to the oceans and the mountains. Right next to the rocks, the ocean and the mountains. I visited many different places. My friends were crying in these concrete sheds. The guys were screaming. We are where they told us to get here, I told my boy. Dripping from my face, there were other people. I couldn't really find anyone to say good morning. There are some warlocks, bloody warlocks. And I told them, you're crazy. And they said, that is not true. All of these crosses were seen, and there were some sheds covered with something. They cut my shoulder with a knife, and I felt my arm falling into the grass. And with it, with my arm, they beat my friends, and they keep on doing that. But when my parents were being beaten, I ran to vomit. The meadows were there in all of those vomiting I was. The clouds and the mountains were getting closer to me. What do you do? What is your name? They were asking me. He's got a nice ass, they said. What do you do? What's your name? They asked me. But my love, it is sticking into the rocks, the ocean and mountains, and my love, it is adhering to the ocean, rocks, and the mountains. They do not know these concrete sheds. They are. I come in with my friends. We're all crying. I'm coming from many different places. I come crying. I also smoke. I come in with guys. Smoking is good for watching different colors, but we're being beaten right in front of doors. Everything is going to be new. That's what I'm telling you, my beautiful boy. The guard said, yes, we need to eliminate this cancer from its root. Yes, this shoulder was bleeding. My shoulder was bleeding. My blood smelled funny. Everything was around, and I could see these two big concrete sheds, TNT, and some wires are covering their broken glasses. But they will never find us, because our love is together, sticking to the rocks, the mountains and the ocean, sticking right next to the rocks, the ocean and the mountains, sticking to the rocks, the ocean and the mountains, sticking to the rocks, the ocean and the mountains, sticking all over again, sticking to the rocks, mountains and the ocean. My boy and my girl died, all of them disappeared. Deserts of love.
Canto de amor a los países.
Singing of love to different countries.
¿Te acuerdas del primer abandono cuando niño?
Do you remember the first abandonment when you were a child?
Sí, dicen.
Yes, he says.
¿Te acuerdas del
segundo? Do you remember the second abandonment when you were 20-something?
Sí, dicen.
Yes, he replies.
¿Sabes, chileno y palomo,
do you know, Chilean
muertos?
Guy, that we're dead?
Sí, dicen.
Yes, they answer.
¿Recuerdas entonces
do you remember then your first poem?
Sí, dice.
Yes, they say.
Dice, sí.
They say
dice,
yes.
Sí.
You
sí.
Say yes.
Sí.
Yes. Yes.
La. 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 La noche canta, canta, canta. Ella
singing
canta,
and singing.
Canta.
She's singing under the earth.
Aparece entonces.
So there,
de nueva,
rise up, get up
muertos,
from these dying countries, Chilean guys, karatecas and betrayers, get up
de nuevo,
and fly again, sing again, and only because love for you, you're going to fly. So you should return this love to this poet who has disappeared from love. He has disappeared from love. He is bad, an evil dove. He is an evil dove. Thank you.
Gracias, buenas noches.
Thank you very much and good evening.
Muchas gracias al señor González.
I want to thank Mr. González and Los Asistentes Band. Let's give them a warm round of applause. Because love for our beloved ones and the ones who have disappeared and died, it is here with us and forever, and it is there. Right in the ocean, in the rocks, in the desert as well, the mountains. Yes, it is true. That is what Raúl Zurita said. And that is what we're saying now from the good journalism. And we take the chance to say that over here, in this audience, there are some of those marvelous colleagues that made those images. They took those images. And that is history. It is part of Teleanálisis history. Thank you very much for the work that you did. December 17, 1918, Colombian journalist Guillermo Canizas was killed right in front of his offices, El Espectador in Bogotá. He died in service, and his legacy, it is a commitment for the defense of the freedom of expression, journalism, independent one, strong, and also for diversity of opinions. Life of Guillermo Cano, it is a solid example of how journalism, which is independent, the good journalism, contributes to this good functioning of society. But also his death symbolizes the high price that pay and keep on paying many of our colleagues, both men and women, in different places of the world, and today more than yesterday, just for the fact or doing, following that commitment of life, which is informing and reporting, defending life. Created in 1997, the World Press Freedom Prize, UNESCO, Guillermo Cano, is granted every year to award one person, organization, or institution which has contributed remarkably to the defense and or promotion of press freedom anywhere in the world, especially when this has been achieved under risk circumstances. How dreadful that we have to celebrate something like that. Celebrate the ones who sometimes even give their lives just for informing and reporting. I can't stop thinking in those dead persons. And maybe no one would ever know if it wasn't for our colleagues working there. All of those different roads and paths in Latin America, I mean, going all the way down to from Mexico, fleeing for misery and violence, entering into South America, working in the mining industry in the Venezuelan or Brazilian Amazon, because organized crime kills, corruption kills. And if it wasn't for our colleagues reporting that, who get into those areas, we would have never known about that, about those dead peoples that belong to no one, and we do care about them. Therefore, we want to take this opportunity for thanking all of the ones who, together with this Guillermo Cano Foundation, make possible this World Press Freedom Prize UNESCO Guillermo Cano. First of all, I want to thank UNESCO. It is not here written, but I don't care about that. Without UNESCO, we wouldn't have anything. Democracy Foundation at Media, El Singing, Sand Mine, so I hope I'm pronouncing them properly, Namibia Media Trust, and the Thompson Foundation, Roy. Thank you. We thank them because we can celebrate once again all of those journalists who risk their lives for the commitment they have taken. I'd like to invite you now to remember and to keep in your mind some of the ones who were awarded with this World Press Freedom Prize UNESCO Guillermo Cano. Because with them, we are granting some tribute to all of those who are still giving an example of what we should do and that we shouldn't forget.
Supe de que Guillermo hubiera tenido amenazas, aunque a través del tiempo creo que sí las hubo, pero no nos las dijo tal vez para no preocuparnos.
И раптом к одному годом до меня приезжаюсь, хапаюсь. И кажут, что все, ты уже обвинуваченный. Приводят в колонию, там я чую погрозы, что ты, журналист, будешь отказывать за все. Ну, я был подрихтованный до того, что, что может меня там чакать. Но, конечно, такого тиску, який я спознал в колонии, я не чакал.
In 2016, I was getting an average of 90 hate messages per hour. Imagine if you were getting 90 hate messages per hour. It attacks you at the core of your insecurities, and you must come out of it.
Creo que no hay una profesión que pueda servir mejor y más a la humanidad que es. Tenemos que, en muchos casos, ser valientes.
Como ven, tenemos mucho
As you can see, we've got so many things to be proud about, not only pain. And the ones that are not here will always be there, but we need to continue. We need to go on because the death is out there and because life is calling for us. And the call of life is so powerful. Now I'm going to start with this part of the ceremony, which is the best part of it, the celebration. I would like to ask María José Medellín Cano, who is the granddaughter of Guillermo Cano. In the almost 40 years that have happened since your grandfather was murdered, Guillermo Cano, the family Guillermo Cano y Sasa not only led the efforts to find the truth and to seek for justice, supported by a wonderful organization in Colombia, and here we have Pedro Vaca, who has been an important driver, Jaime Abello from Gavo Foundation, that demonstrated the strength, the example of Guillermo Cano. And also, your foundation has continued with his legacy by supporting the promotion of the freedom of press and of speech all over the world by means of the foundation that carries his name. So I would like to give you the floor. Thank you very much. Good evening, everyone. I would like to start saying that I don't have Monica's presence, but my words is on behalf of my family and my grandfather as well. And I really thank you for the respect and the love, especially for everybody who is here. 27 years ago, there were this award, UNESCO Guillermo Cano World Prize, Freedom Prize. Everybody knew that this recognition had to do one thing, to distinguish a person, organization, or a collective of people that would have to standing promotion to the freedom of speech and press all over the world, especially if that contribution was done or was done in under conditions of danger. During 27 years under that premise, the organizers and the jury, they have been looking all over the world by looking for the job of those journalists that have been imprisoners, murderers, and so on. The long list of winners is nothing else than the testimony of 27 human beings whose voices were censored, voices that were researching, and they were doing things that many wanted to keep quiet. They were brave, independent voices that were fiscalizing the power, voices that are shouting out to be heard among the all this noise of the bomb, of the bombs, and beyond any oppressions or threats or danger, we should have the premises of every citizen that we need to have the right to live in peace and to be informed. That's why my grandfather used to believe in that. We believe the peace to live in a civilized manner and to stop dying like savages. He was so right about it. It was even about 30 years ago. So when we announced the new awarded person, I know that it's not going to be the exception of those qualities of excellence and courage that has been the characteristic of this award. So we need voices like that, and like never before, those voices need the backup and all the contributions to continue with their fight, because as we have seen during the last 27 years, sometimes it will take, we will lose our lives just trying to achieve that. This prize, Guillermo Cano, is what we need in order to continue having this freedom of press. So from Guillermo Cano y Sasa, we will need to tell you about our commitment. We will continue protecting this light of hope with the hope that no society will have to give the goodbyes to another journalist because he was murdered, or any other grandchild like myself will be missing a grandfather that I never met. From Guillermo Cano Foundation, we would like to recognize UNESCO and all their workers for the years that I have been working and
with the, all the commitment, with the essence of this award. Thank you very much to all the journalists all over the world. Thank you very much, everybody. It's so important to have the granddaughter of Guillermo Cano here. It is almost to have a live message that life goes on. I would love my grandchildren will remember me like this. Thank you, Maria Jose, so much for the commitment, for your commitment and your family's commitment, and for given this turn to impunity, for continue being there, because justice is key. No any other murder of any colleague should be left there without justice. So that's why I would like to thank you, because the example in the promotion of freedom and also of the good journalism is an inspiration to all of us, and you have been an inspiration tonight. And now we will start with the award ceremony itself. And I would like to give the floor to Mr. Tafik Jelassi, Honorary Director of Communication and Information of UNESCO. And he will tell us who is the awarder from Santiago de Chile, who is the winner. Maybe it is she or he or maybe them who are going to be awarded.
Excellency Minister Camila Vallejo, Excellencies Ambassadors and diplomats present with us this evening, esteemed journalists, media professionals, dear President and members of the International Jury for the Prize, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. As the UNESCO Assistant Director General for Communication and Information, it's an honor and a privilege to stand before you this evening on behalf of our organization for this important and prestigious award. Nobel laureate Maria Ressa has said, without facts, you can't have the truth. Without truth, you can't have trust. And without trust, we have no shared reality. These statements still resonate deeply with the man after whom the World Press Freedom Prize is named. Guillermo Cano was a living example of journalistic excellence through his unwavering commitment to seeking and documenting the truth. As an editor and director of the newspaper El Espectador, this brilliant Colombian journalist's life and career were marked by his dedication to independent journalism, the defense of press freedom, and the promotion of peace. He fearlessly fought against the drug cartels and their detrimental effects on Colombian society, and for this, he has ultimately paid the highest price. Today, as we gather here to honor the legacy of Guillermo Cano and to recognize through him those who have followed in his footsteps, we pay tribute to all journalists who have risked their lives, faced persecution, and even paid the highest price in the pursuit of truth and peace. I would like to extend my heartfelt gratitude to Anna Maria Busquets and the Cano Izaza family for their efforts not only to keep alive the memory of Guillermo Cano, but also to carry on the legacy of their husband, father, and grandfather through the work of the foundation. I also wish to express my sincere appreciation to the sponsors of the prize. These are the Guillermo Cano Isaza Foundation, the Democracy and Media Foundation, the Helsinki Sanoman Sasio Foundation, the Namibia Media Trust, and the Thomson Reuters Foundation. And of course, I would like to extend my heartfelt appreciation to the jury, chair, and members for their hard work throughout the selection process. After I announce this year's laureates in just a moment, we'll hear from the president of the international jury, Mr. Mauricio Weibel, accompanied by jury member, Ms. Mai Azango, who will explain the rationale that has led to the jury's decision. We will then welcome representatives of the laureates on stage. And so, without further ado, in my capacity as UNESCO Assistant Director General for Communication and Information, I am honored to announce the 2024 UNESCO Guillermo Cano World Press Freedom Prize, which is awarded following the recommendation of the International Jury of Media Professionals to Palestinian journalists covering Gaza. At a time when conflicts spread and threats to press freedom are ever present and growing all over the world, the need for professional media workers committed to bring reliable and verified information to the public is so crucial. The ongoing conflict in Gaza has posed extreme risks and challenges to journalists undertaking their vital work to provide life-saving information to the population and to inform the world about the situation on the ground. Never in a recent conflict has the profession had to pay such a heavy price in a very short period of time. UNESCO has, since the beginning of the conflict, been closely monitoring the situation and has repeatedly called for all actors to respect international law and to protect journalists as civilians. UNESCO has individually condemned or deplored every journalist's death in the line of work and has been providing basic necessities to those that continue to report despite the intense difficulties, and to women journalists in particular. I would like now to invite the president of the international jury to speak to you in more detail about the reasons behind the jury's decision. Thank you for your attention.
Creo que estamos todos
I believe that we're all we've been shaken with this massacre that's happening there in Gaza.
Y por eso,
and that's why
esto nos tiene
we are
emocionados, ¿no?
We're so moved.
Ya subieron, ya están con nosotros,
they're here on stage with us. We have the president of the jury,
Mauricio Biden,
and Mae Azam.
Así que voy a dejar
so,
sin más a este jurado.
I will leave them
la gracia de este
over
premio
here because the
es que
good thing about this press it is that it is chosen by us,
por colega, por
by colleagues, by an independent jury, by colleagues from all over the world,
que representan a,
representing
a medios de comunicación,
mass media
de regiones,
from regions, from so many different places all
eso
over the world.
Bonito,
that's the beautiful part of this, that is so, which is so moving, and that makes us
manos, corazones,
shaking hands
con más fuerza
and celebrating.
Biden.
Mr. Biden.
¿Qué noche?
What a night.
Bueno.
Well.
Queridas autoridades.
Dear authorities.
Queridos colegas.
Dear colleagues.
Queridos y queridas amigas.
Dear friends.
El jurado hoy.
The jury.
Queremos transmitir.
We want to convey
a
message of concern.
Por la situación global.
Because of the global situations that journalists are living
hoy
on
nosotros,
all over the world.
Los periodistas,
we journalists, through all over the world, we're facing.
Los trabajadores de la prensa,
and the press workers, we're being kidnapped, we're being killed, murdered,
digital,
digital harassment, persecution,
desapariciones,
disappearance, arbitrary detentions. We're suffering from all that. Hatred, speeches, and restrictions in the access to information. As a member of the jury, we believe that persecution against journalists, both men and women, are always an attack to democracy and freedom of expression. We're living times which are so harsh and hard. Many journalists must be exiled or are exiled with their families. Even in other countries, foreign countries, they or their relatives are killed, they are murdered. So in this context, the jury wants to thank, wants to celebrate, and wants to support all of the initiatives in all of the continents, in all of the countries, defending and promoting the freedom of speech. It is so necessary. Likewise, in these times of darkness, and when we're losing hope, we want to convey a message of solidarity and acknowledgement to all of the Palestinian journalists. As mankind, we believe that we have a debt, a huge debt, with the courage and the commitment they are having with this freedom of speech. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Finally, dear friends, authorities and colleagues, I want to ask you, please, let's be silent for 1 minute for all of the ones, for all of the journalists, both men and women, who have been murdered in Gaza.
Muchas gracias. Para nosotros ha sido un honor.
To us, it has been a pleasure.
Importante momento porque creo
it is an important moment because I truly believe that together with the celebrating, we are going to remember some faces of our colleagues who have left an important footprint that we will never forget, because the pages of horrors, we are also the journalists who are in charge, that they will be part of our memory to try that this will never happen again, something that today seems to be so far away. Thank you, Mauricio, for your kind words. And also, so I would like to invite once again Mr. Gelassi, Maria Jesus, please. And I would like to invite all the Palestinian journalists who are here in the room. I think there is more than one. If you could come to the stage with us. The journalists from Palestine, please come to the stage. I understood there was someone else, but maybe not. So, Mr. Nasser. Nasser, you're here. Thank you very much for being here with us today. And well, he is representing all those colleagues that this jury so wonderfully wanted to award during this night here in Santiago de Chile to summon this by saying, stop, we don't want to continue informing massacres. So with this, I would like to ask you to give the diploma in representation of all of our colleagues that throughout the internet channels of this wonderful communication, which is the digital, they will know that today they are the awarded ones. Dear colleague Abu Bakr, maybe you would like to take the floor, please. Please, I can have it for you.
Good evening for all of you. Thank you for your supporting and for your feeling. I feel that you are happy with this decision from the UNESCO, so that I thank all of you and thank your support. I decided to speak in Arabic language because this award is for my colleagues in Gaza, and they speak Arabic, so must be talk with their language in Arabic. السلام على غزة لأنها تستحق السلام، والسلام على صحفيي غزة وعموم فلسطين الذين يستحقون الحب والأمل والسلام. السلام على صحفيي غزة الذين لم يعرفوا النوم ولا طعم الحياة منذ 7 أشهر، لكنهم ظلوا متمسكين بمبادئ مهنة الصحافة وأخلاقياتها
وظلت نقابة الصحفيين الفلسطينيين متمسكة بمبادئ الدفاع عن حرية الصحافة وحماية الصحفيين في فلسطين.
Peace to Gaza because it deserves it. Peace to Gaza and the journalists of Gaza and all of Palestine who deserve love and hope. Peace to the journalists of Gaza who have not slept for 7 months, yet they have remained committed to the principles and ethics of journalism. Their union, the Palestinian Journalist Syndicate, has remained committed to the principles of defending press freedom and protecting journalists.
نقف اليوم أمامكم بهذا الحدث التاريخي العظيم بمنح اليونسكو ولجنة كانو لجنة جائزة حرية الصحافة للصحفيين الفلسطينيين الذين غطوا الحرب على غزة والتي تسلمتها قبل قليل. وكم أشعر بالفخر والفرح، لكنه الفرح الممزوج بالحزن على فراق شهداء الصحافة الفلسطينية، وأيضاً ممزوج بالتصميم والإرادة على محاسبة ومحاكمة القتلة المجرمين الذين قتلوا هذه الكوكبة من الصحفيين.
Today we stand before you with this great historical event, with the award of the UNESCO Guillermo Cano World Press Freedom Prize to Palestinian journalists covering the war on Gaza, which was handed over to me a little while ago. I feel joy and pride, but it's a joy mixed with a sadness for the loss of the martyrs of the Palestinian press. It is also mixed with determination and willingness to hold accountable and prosecute the criminals who killed this constellation.
السيد توفيق جلاسي مساعد المدير عام اليونسكو للإعلام والاتصال، السادة أعضاء لجنة اليونسكو جائزة كانو، السادة طاقم وطواقم اليونسكو، السادة السلك الدبلوماسي والرسمي، السادة الحضور كل باسمه ومسماه، إنه لشرف عظيم أن أقف اليوم بينكم وأمامكم لأتحدث باسم صحفيي فلسطين في غزة الحبيبة. إنهم صوت الحق الذي ظل يصدح في أركان المعمورة أجمع. جئتكم اليوم من وطني فلسطين إلى سانتياغو لأتحدث باسم صحفيي غزة، شهود الحقيقة وشهود على أبشع وأكبر مجزرة شهدها الإعلام في تاريخه راح ضحيتها حتى الآن 135 صحفياً. وأوضح أنه كان من المفترض أن يكون معنا اليوم على هذه المنصة زميل عزيز وصديق حبيب، أخي الصحفي وائل الدحدوح، عضو نقابة الصحفيين، ولكن وضعه الصحي لم يسمح له بالتواجد للأسف بيننا.
Mr. Tawfiq Jelassi, Assistant Director General of UNESCO, members of UNESCO Guillermo Cano Jury, the Diplomatic and Official Corps. Ladies and gentlemen, it is a great honor for me to stand today before you to speak on behalf of Palestinian journalists in our beloved Gaza. They are the voice of truth and will continue to resound in the corners of the world. I came to you today from my homeland, Palestine, to Santiago to speak on behalf of the journalists of Gaza. Witnesses, torture, witnesses to truth and witness to the worst and largest slaughter that the media has witnessed. More than 135 journalists have been killed so far. My colleague and brother journalist Wael Dahdouh, a member of the Palestinian Journalist Syndicate, was supposed to stand with us today on this platform, but his health condition did not allow him to be present.
7 أشهر مرت على هذه الحرب بكل تفاصيلها وفصولها المرعبة، حيث قتل بها الاحتلال الإسرائيلي خيرة الخيرة من صحفيين، ودمر أكثر من 80 مؤسسة إعلامية، وشرد الصحفيين في الخيام وساحات المستشفيات، وأصابوا بجروح العشرات من الصحفيين وقتلوا المئات من عائلاتهم ودمروا بيوت أطفالهم ودمروا بيوتهم ويتموا أطفالهم. لقد أصبح ثمن نقل الحقيقة هو حياة الصحفي، وأحياناً كثيرة حياته وحياة أسرته. ومع ذلك ظل صحفيون في غزة ينقلون ما تتعرض له غزة من حرب إبادة هي الأبشع في تاريخ الإنسانية جمعاء.
7 months have passed since this war began, with all its details and terrifying chapters, in which the Israeli occupation killed the best of our journalists, destroyed more than 80 media institutions, displaced journalists in tents and hospital yards, and injured dozens of them. The lives of journalists have become the price of reporting the truth in Palestine, and in many cases, the life of their families. However, our journalists in Gaza have continued to report on the most horrific war in the history of humanity.
تم منع الصحفيين الأجانب أيضاً حتى هذه اللحظة من دخول غزة للتغطية الإعلامية، وهو ما لم يحصل في العالم أجمع إلا من قبل الاحتلال الإسرائيلي.
Foreign journalists have been prevented from entering Gaza for media coverage, which is unprecedented.
لقد عمل صحفيو غزة تحت القصف وبين الجثث والدمار وفي البرد القارس والجوع والعطش لأشهر، وخسروا منازلهم وبعض أفراد أسرهم، لكنهم ظلوا يعملوا بأرقى المعايير المهنية. لم يزوروا صورة ولا خبر، ولم يحرضوا ضد أحد رغم التحريض عليهم لقتلهم. وكل يقين أنهم أصبحوا أهم نموذج مهني يعمل المستحيل لنقل الحقيقة رغم بحر الدماء الذي سال منهم.
Gaza journalists have worked under shelling, among corpses and destruction, in extreme cold, hunger and thirst for months, and have lost their homes and family members. Nevertheless, they have continued to work with the highest professional standards. They did not falsify any pictures or news and did not incite anyone against anyone else, despite the incitement to hatred against them. I am certain that they have become the most important professional model, one that does the impossible to convey the truth despite the sea of blood.
إنني وأنا أقف أمامكم أتذكر العشرات بل المئات من زملائي وزميلاتي في مهنة الصحافة في غزة الحبيبة، أعضاء نقابة الصحفيين الذين عملت معهم في مهنة الصحافة وفي العمل النقابي في غزة. المأساة كبيرة جداً في غزة، وتغطية تفاصيلها من قبل صحفيين هناك كان محورياً لكشف الحقيقة. إن قلبي ينزف دماً على وجعهم ومعاناتهم، حيث أستمع يومياً لتفاصيل المأساة التي يجب أن تتوقف فوراً. ولكن رغم الوجع، إلا أن إرادتهم قوية وإصرارهم لن يتوقف مهما ارتكب الاحتلال من جرائم بحقهم. لقد أرادوا قتل غزة وشعبنا الفلسطيني فيها، لكن أقول ما قاله الشاعر الفلسطيني الكبير والشاعر الكوني الكبير محمود درويش: غزة لا تموت لأنها جديرة بالحياة. وأنا أقول أن صحفيي غزة لن يموتوا لأنهم يمتلكوا الإرادة والتصميم. وقال أيضاً درويش: قبل 20 عاماً إن سألوك عن غزة قل لهم بها شهيد، يسعفه شهيد ويصوره شهيد ويودعه شهيد ويصلي عليه شهيد. هذا هو حال الغزي، وهذا هو حال الصحفيين في غزة.
As I stand before you, I remember dozens or even hundreds of colleagues, journalists in our beloved Gaza, members of the syndicate. The tragedy in Gaza is so severe, and the courage of its details by journalists in Gaza journalists has been pivotal to the uncovering of the truth. My heart bleeds for their pain and suffering as I listen daily to the details of the tragedy that must stop. But despite the pain, their will is strong and their determination will never stop, no matter what the occupation does to them. They want to kill Gaza and our Palestinian people, but I would quote the international Palestinian poet Mahmoud Darwish. Gaza does not die because it knows the value of life, and the journalists of Gaza would not die because they have a will and determination. Darwish also said 20 years ago, if they ask you about Gaza, tell them, it's a martyr and a martyr. This is the case of Gazans, and this is the state of Gazan journalists.
Okay. الحضور الكريم إن قرار اليونسكو ولجنة كانو بمنح جائزة حرية الصحافة لهذا العام 2024 لكافة الصحفيين الذين غطوا الحرب على غزة هو بحد ذاته نعتبره رسالة قوية تلقيناها بكل تقدير. مفادها أن العدالة للصحفيين سوف تتحقق، وأن منظمات الأمم المتحدة بدأت تأخذ دورها في إنصافنا كصحفيين، وعلى رأسها اليونسكو المنظمة المختصة في الأمم المتحدة بحماية الصحفيين وحرية الإعلام وفي تحقيق وتطبيق القانون الدولي بما يخص حماية الإعلام وحماية الصحفيين. وبعد مرور 7 أشهر لا أستطيع أن أصدق عدد الزملاء الذين فقدناهم. كانت هناك أوقات شعروا فيها أن العالم قد انصرف عنهم، وهذا ليس مفاجئ نظراً لحجم الخسارة، وخاصة الذين فقدوا عائلاتهم بأكملها. ومع ذلك فإن هذه الجائزة التي أفتخر بتسلمها باعتباري رئيساً لنقابة الصحفيين نيابة عن كل الصحفيين في غزة هي دليل إيجابي على هذا الدعم، وأن قضية الصحفيين في غزة لن تمر مرور الكرام.
Distinguished audience, the recommendation of the UNESCO Guillermo Cano jury to award the 2024 World Press Freedom Prize to all Palestinian journalists covering Gaza is in itself a strong message that we receive with appreciation. Justice for journalists will be achieved, and the United Nations organizations have begun to take their role in doing justice to journalists, including UNESCO, the United Nations organization with a mandate to promote the protection of journalists and media freedom and the application of international law regarding the protection of media freedom and the protection of journalists. 7 months later, I cannot believe how many colleagues we have lost. There were times when they felt like the world had turned away. This is not surprising, given the scale of the loss, especially the number of those who have lost their entire families. However, this award, which I'm proud to collect on behalf of all of them, is a positive proof that their suffering has not gone unnoticed.
ومن هنا من سانتياغو نقول للعالم أجمع أن نقابة الصحفيين ومعها الاتحاد الدولي للصحفيين IFJ وكافة نقابات الصحفيين والاتحادات في العالم ماضون في إجراءاتنا لمقاضاة مرتكبي الجرائم بحق الصحفيين الفلسطينيين. ونطالب النائب العام للمحكمة الجنائية الدولية السيد كريم خان بسرعة بدء إجراءات التحقيق في هذه الجرائم من أجل تطبيق قرارات الأمم المتحدة بعدم إفلات مرتكبي الجرائم بحق الصحفيين الفلسطينيين من العقاب.
From here in Santiago, we say to the whole world that the Journalist Syndicate, together with the International Federation of Journalists and all journalist unions in the world, will continue to persecute the perpetrators of crimes against journalists. We call on the prosecutor of the International Criminal Court, Mr. Karim Khan, to quickly start investigating these crimes in order to implement the United Nations resolutions to ensure that perpetrators of crimes against journalists do not go unpunished.
السيدات والسادة، يشاء القدر أن يكرم اليوم الصحفيين الفلسطينيين الذين غطوا الحرب على غزة وهم أعضاء في نقابة الصحفيين بأهم جائزة لحرية الصحافة تمنحها اليونسكو في وقت يتزامن مع الذكرى المئوية لتأسيس أول نقابة للصحفيين الفلسطينيين عام 1924، أي قبل 100 عام. ونشكر الاتحاد الدولي للصحفيين ونقابات الصحفيين في العالم، ونشكر إدارة وطواقم اليونسكو في باريس وفي رام الله وفي عموم العالم على وقوفهم مع العدالة واحترامهم وتقديرهم لضحايا الحرب على غزة وتكريمهم لصمودهم ونقلهم حقيقة المأساة برغم التحديات الجمة والظروف اللا إنسانية التي يمرون بها.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Palestinian journalists who have covered the war on Gaza, including all members of the Palestinian Journalist Syndicate, are honored today with the most important Press Freedom Award in the world, awarded by UNESCO at a time that coincides with the 100th anniversary of the establishment of the first Palestinian Journalist Syndicate in Palestine, the first in the Arab world. We thank the International Federation of Journalists and UNESCO in Paris and Ramallah for standing for justice, for respecting and appreciating the journalists that are among the victims of the war in Gaza, and honoring them for their steadfastness and for conveying the truth of the tragedy despite the great challenges and inhumane conditions they are faced with.
سنبقى الأوفياء لمبادئ حقوق الإنسان والحرية والعدالة وحرية الصحافة، وستبقى نقابة الصحفيين في فلسطين حارسة الحريات والمدافع الأمين عن حرية الصحافة والصحفيين باعتبارها حق مقدس للصحفيين.
We will remain faithful to the principles of human rights, freedom and justice. The Palestinian Journalist Syndicate will remain the guardian of freedoms in Palestine and the faithful defender of freedom of the press and journalists as a sacred right for journalists.
إن منح جائزة حرية الصحافة بالتأكيد لن تعيد لنا أحبتنا الشهداء الصحفيين في غزة، ولكنها أعادت بالتأكيد الأمل أن العالم مع العدالة. شكرا لكم جميعا.
Finally, the awarding of this Press Freedom Award will certainly not bring back our beloved martyred journalists, but it has restored our hope that the world is for justice. Thank you all.
I would like, in the end, and then that I would like to thank you, all of you, for your support. And in behalf of me, President of Palestinian Journalists Syndicate, and my board, and all members in the syndicate, we are 4,000 journalists. We are thank all of you about your position, about your feeling. And I would like to thank our lawyer in ICC, Jennifer Robinson. She is surprised me that she is here. Thank you, Jennifer. Thank you, all of you.
Bueno, les damos las gracias al presidente del Sindicato de los Periodistas Palestinos, Nasser Abu Bakr, por sus palabras. Y me gustaría que de pie le brindemos un tremendo aplauso.
I'd like to give a warm round of applause because all through the platforms, this is going to get in different times and moments. This is going to get to all of the journalists. Palestinian journalists who are covering this massacre there in Gaza. This has been an important moment, and we're happy because we're doing it from here, from Santiago, here in Chile. We're getting to the very end, and just to close, I want to invite the Minister Secretary General of the Government, Camila Vallejo, to address some words. Just to close this ceremony, which has been vibrant.
Estimada Gloria de la Fuente,
dear Gloria de la Fuente, and Secretary of Foreign Affairs,
estimada Nicole Cardoche,
dear Nicole Cardoche, and the Secretary of the General Secretary of the Government, Regional Director of UNESCO, Esther Cuchile Roche, dear Esther, dear Gael García Bernal,
actor, director,
Mexican, actor, activist of the defense of the environment, President and members of the jury of this Guillermo Cano for Press Freedom, President Mr. Mauricio Wyvern. It is a pleasure to be with you once again.
María José Medellín Cano,
granddaughter of Guillermo Cano, pleasure to meet you. Pleasure to listen to you as well.
Tawfiq
Jelsi, I've been honored to be in many different working instances. You don't require any other presentation, introduction, diplomatic body. Our awarded and dear representative of the Palestinian journalist, Nasser Abu Bakr. Congratulations. And together with you, I want to greet the whole Palestinian people. And this is an homage for the more than 35,000 Palestinians who have been murdered in this brutal massacre, which continues up until today. So with you, I mean, Chile is supporting you, and we're going to keep on supporting you. We wish we could do more of what we have done to conclude or finish this massacre, which has been brutal. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Chile, to Santiago. Our country is opening once again its doors to the world in an instance which is solemn, multilateral. We're commemorating and celebrating at the same time, acknowledging the work being done by journalists and communicators from all over the world in order to protect our fundamental rights. In a world, crazy world such as ours, where war it is once again present, leaving behind so much destruction and death, where there are some tensions, socioeconomic tensions, which are so intense, ethnical ones, gender, religious ones as well, and have been breaking peace and social convivence more and more. In this context, crazy context, it is important more than ever to acknowledge journalists, men and women, which are taking the risk to defend or promoting press of speech everywhere, all over the world, because this job, it is fundamental nowadays for taking care of our democracies, for taking care of life. In a world where our democracies are threatened by this global phenomenon of misinformation and the usage of it as a factic power, information and the truth are a tool, an instrument which is so necessary and so powerful at the same time, where both journalists, men and women, must be and are the guardians of truth and reality. Their role goes beyond informing. We all know that. A huge example is Monica Gonzalez. They build some narratives, they decodify and they present society data which shape our perception of the world. In conditions which oftentimes are so adverse, they face some threats, they also face censorship. They also face some dangers which are unthinkable, with the main motivation of showing what many try to hide. This act needs bravery, courage, and a conviction and a commitment which is deep in the democratic principles of freedom and justice. In this sense, journalists' work requires a high ethical value, which is not trained all or taught only at universities. It is developed in journalism itself, in working and exploring in taking every single step of life. Journalist ethics, it is crucial because it guides the pen, the voice, or the camera towards a vocation of being or conveying truth. Accuracy and justice is also present. This ethics, it is the one that assures that information which is being shared is going to be an instrument of lightening and not manipulation and deceiving. That's why this ethical work of our journalists, not only it is a responsibility, professional one, but also it has some consequences in the entire society. It has consequences in its final destination and destiny. Considering the former, I'd like to remind you all, and since we're here in Chile, the history of a journalist and writer, Chilean woman, Patricia Verdugo. Please, a warm round of applause for her. Patricia Verdugo lived censorship during the dictatorship. She defended democracy and human rights. Patricia believed in the following, I quote, "When you say that reporting, informing, it is a duty, and at the same time, it is the exercise of some other human rights and citizen rights, which are basic, a journalist is aware of its roles as defending factic powers, and therefore it also defends on behalf of the people or peoples which choose their representatives, and they pay for them to do their job with probity." End of quote. Patricia was following that ethics and this exercise of the journalist's work, just like millions of women and men who in this duty often face the factic powers, willing to perpetuate agendas without any democratic deliberation, presenting data which are real or some backgrounds which are distorted, distort reality, and do harm citizens, democracy, and also social organization. These trusts are fundamental, and they're also a priority in order to advance in society which is altogether, and that allows us to advance in social justice, fundamental rights, equality, equity, among some others. Journalists, both men and women, have demonstrated that with determination, they can challenge these factic powers. We all know that this job is not an easy one, and many of them have paid a price which has been way too high. But their struggle, it is the living sign of a pillar of democracy against corruption, organized crime, against authoritarianism, against destruction of our environment, against this hatred speech, against gender violence, against misinformation. There are some journalists and communicators who have transformed into some examples of the journalist's work, and they have demonstrated that their voices must be heard, they must be respected, and they must be protected. In this sense, as a government here in Chile, we want to reiterate our commitment, various commitment, with the protection of journalists, both men and women, because they are the ones who allow to safeguard press of speech and expression, which is the main engine of a society which is free. Friends, I want to congratulate all of the nominated ones, because thanks to their job and work, through their eyes, through their work, the world sees the stories of the ones who would be invisible otherwise, and their voices are oftentimes the first to be heard, defending the truth and defending the ones who are unprotected. Their work helps governments and administrations to advance in public policies. It also helps advancing in corruption when it is taken into the light. They build social agendas, strengthening democracy, and therefore they strengthen the work of the free press. But I want to especially greet and salute Nasser Abu Bakr, President of the Unions of Journalists Palestinian, and he's been awarded with this Guillermo Cano Award today. Nasser, you're representing the value of working of the thousands of journalists, men and women, who are present in the Palestinian Union. And we're symbolizing this international support for the defense of the determination of the Palestinian people. From Chile, we want to express that in a strong and clear way, because just like in our countries, we cry and we're so sorry and we condemn when a person, a civilian, is murdered because of crime, organized crime. Of course, we're moved. We're going to condemn, or we're going to reject strongly the murder of more than 35,000 Palestinians, more than 12,000 boys and girls. Thank you for your work. Thank you for showing this reality. Thank you for moving the world. And thank you for, because through this work, all the countries, more and more, can get united in order to raise our voices to stop this brutal and systematic crime, this massacre, this genocide, because it is organized. There is a government to massacre another people, and that's something we cannot allow nowhere in the world. As a minister and representative of the Chilean government, and on behalf of the President Gabriel Boric, but especially as a citizen of this country, I feel deeply thankful and proud of each journalist making an effort for showing the truth, making an effort for maintaining the ideal of a free press is not only part of our democracy, but it is an essential condition. Just to conclude, I want to invite you all, so all together, we continue supporting and protecting our journalists, but also all of the workers, all of the people working in communications, because they are the ones who are sure that their light will never end up in the darkness which they are trying to fight against. This legacy of Guillermo Cano should inspire us all to value defending and demanding the truth. Thank you very much. Good evening.
Qué noche, ¿eh?
What a night. What a night we have had. We have been through so many emotions and so many commitments that hopefully we do not forget about it. That's why we're journalists, because we are that memory, that the one that is there, like your conscience, that reminds you, where are we going? Where do we come from? Where are we? Yes, we feed the memory, the good journalism. That is why we are the enemy number one of corruption, of the old dictators and the new ones, the assassins, the abusers, the exploiters, and the ones who wants to kill us, and the ones to kill other peoples, and they want nobody to know about it. So just to finish, after going through this, remembering José Carrasco, Guillermo Cano, and Patricia Verdugo as well, my best friend, who is no longer among us. I just want to say that
This is from Santiago. We are those drops. All of our colleagues who are here is the ones that follow us from the different platforms. We're just drops that we are feeding that river of oxygen, of water, of truth, of information. The commitment is that that river should never get dry, that will never cut the flow. Here we are, here we go. And from Santiago, we promise to feed it more and more. Thank you, my dear colleagues, here and all over the world. Thank you to the watered ones. Thank you to our colleagues from Palestine because of the huge sacrifice to our colleagues that each one of our countries, today they are fighting for the freedom, for the survival of a democracy that it is more and more complicated, for life, for the right to love and to love each other. So thank you very much, everybody, to our colleagues, and let's hope that this is a night to remember. Now we've got a cocktail, and you're all invited from here, from the Museum of the Fine Arts here in Santiago. Enjoy.